passing the Tower of London, 5,000 fascists rally to their mobilization for the much-advertised march through the East End. And Sir Oswald Mosley, black shirt leader, arrives at Royal Mint Street to inspect his followers. In Stepney, thousands of East Enders prepare to resist the invasion, barricading the path the fascists will take. 6,000 police are already concentrated in the area. Others are rushed to reinforce them. Communists, Labourites and Jews jam the fascist route, resisting the peaceful efforts of the outnumbered police to clear the way. Incensed by black shirt, anti-red, anti-Jew propaganda, five East End boroughs unsuccessfully petition the Home Office to forbid the march. Now the crowd take matters into their own hands. Mounted police come to colleagues' help. Batons are drawn and heads broken as the anti-fascist demonstrators resist efforts to disperse them. Fighting now spreads to the Mint. Sir Oswald Mosley was informed by the police commissioner, Sir Philip Game, in Trilby hat, that to avert serious bloodshed, the march would ban. A car charges a black shirt crowd to get away. The incident rouses both sides. Blows all round. Minor injuries come thick and fast. Altogether, 84 rioters are taken into custody, while the police firmly prevent the battle from taking an uglier turn. 80 injured are taken to hospital. Hundreds more receive first aid on the spot. From impartial people, the police earn nothing but praise. So does Sir Philip Game in banning the march. Firm action by the commissioner and his men undoubtedly averted bloodshed on a scale more terrible than London has ever witnessed.